Hello friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel Journey with Vijay Kumar Shrivastav. Today our study topic is herbicides, classification and applications. Before presentation, I would like to give a little introduction about myself. I am Vijay Kumar Shrivastav. I have done M.Sc. agriculture with a specialization in agronomy from JV Pant University of Agriculture and Technology, Pantnagar in 1996 and presently working as a seed professional in one of the MNC in seed industry. So let's proceed to the presentation. What is herbicide? Herbicides are chemical used to control weeds. This is the method of chemical weed control. And what are the merits of herbicide use? Recommended for adverse soil and climatic conditions. Applied even before weeds emerge and make the environment weed free. Suitable for all types of crops. Controls the targeted weeds only. Controls many perennial weeds species. And it is cost effective compared to labor expenses. Now to study classification of herbicides. Herbicides are classified on basis of different parameters about which we will study here. First one is classification based on method of application. On this basis, herbicides are divided in two categories. First one is soil applied herbicides. These are the herbicides which act through root and other underground parts of weeds. Such herbicide example is fluchloroline. Second is foliage applied herbicides. These herbicides primarily active on the plant foliages. Examples like glyphosate and paraquat. There are different factors which are influencing the methods of application. Like first one is weed crop situation. Second, type of herbicides. Third, mode of action and selectivity of herbicides. Fourth, environmental factors. And fifth, cost and convenience of application. Second classification of herbicide is based on target site. Depending on the target site, the herbicides are classified into two categories. First one is soil applied herbicides and second is foliage applied or foliar herbicides. In case of soil application herbicides, the application method is like surface method, second is subsurface method, third is band application, fourth is fumigation and fifth is herbigination. While in case of foliar application herbicides, there is blanket spray, directed spray, protected spray and spot treatment. In broad, we will discuss about both soil application herbicides and foliar application herbicides. Here to study about soil application herbicides. First method is surface application. Soil application herbicides are applied uniformly on the surface of the soil, either by spraying or by broadcasting. The applied herbicides are either left undisturbed or incorporated into the soil. Incorporation is done to prevent the volatilization and photodecomposition of the herbicides. Example like fluchloroline, it is left undisturbed under irrigated conditions and incorporated under rain-fed conditions. Second method is subsurface application. It is the application of herbicides in a concentrated band about 7 to 10 cm below the soil surface for controlling perennial weeds. For this special type of nozzle is introduced below the soil under the cover of a sweep hood like carbamate herbicide to control cypress rotundus and nitrilene herbicide to control convolvulus arvensis. Third method is band application. Application to a restricted band along the crop rows, leaving an untreated band in the inter rows. Later inter rows are cultivated to remove the weeds. Saving in cost is possible here. For example, when a 30 cm wide band of a herbicide applied over a crop row that were spaced 90 cm apart, then 2/3 cost is saved. Fourth is fumigation. Application of volatile chemicals into confined spaces or into the soil to produce gas that will destroy weed seeds is called fumigation. Herbicides used for fumigation are called as fumigants. These are good for killing perennial weeds as well as for eliminating weed seeds, like example methyl bromide or methane, etc. Then fifth method is herbigation. Application of herbicides with irrigation water both by surface and sprinkler systems. In India, farmers apply fluchloroline for chilies and tomato, while in western countries application of EPTC with sprinkler irrigation water is very common in lucerne crop. Now to study foliar application herbicides. The first method is blanket spray. Uniform application of herbicides to standing crops without considering the location of the crop is called blanket spray. Only highly selective herbicides are used here, like spraying 2,4-ethyl ester to rice crop after 3 weeks of transplanting. Second method is directed spray. Application of herbicides on weeds in between rows of crops by directing the spray only on weeds avoiding the crop. This could be possible by use of protective shields or hoods. For example, spraying glyphosate in between rows of tapioca using hood to control cypress rotundus. Third method is protected spray. Applying non-selective herbicides on weeds by covering the crops which are wide-spaced with polyethylene covers. This is expensive and laborious. However, farmers are using this technique for spraying glyphosate to control weeds in jasmine, cassava, banana and other crops. Fourth method is spot treatment. It is usually done on small areas having serious weed infestation to kill it and to prevent its spread. Rope wick applicator and herbicide gloves are useful here. Now, third classification of herbicides based on mode of action. First one is selective herbicide. A herbicide is considered a selective when in a mixed growth of plant species, it kills some species without injuring the others. Like example, herbicides atrazine. Second is non-selective herbicide. It destroys majority of treated vegetation like a paraquat. Fourth method of herbicide classification is based on mobility. In this, the herbicides are categorized in two types. First one is contact herbicide. A contact herbicide kills those plant parts with which it comes in direct contact, like paraquat. Second is translocated herbicides. Herbicides which tend to move from treated part to untreated areas through xylem and phloem, depending on the nature of its molecule, like chemical glyphosate. Now, fifth basis of classification of herbicides based on time of application. In this basis, the herbicides are categorized in four types. First one is pre-plant application, PPI. Application of herbicide before sowing or along with sowing. Either it is foliar applied or incorporated in soil soon after its application. Pre-plant foliar spraying of glyphosate to control perennial weeds like cypress rotundus and pre-plant soil incorporation of fluchloroline to control weeds in groundnut. Second herbicide is pre-emergence herbicides. Herbicide is applied to control soon after sowing a crop before emergence of weeds. And the examples like atrazine, pendimethalin, butachlor, thiobencarb and preticlor, etc. Third, herbicides are post-emergence herbicide. When herbicide is applied to kill young weeds standing in the crop plants or application after the emergence of weed and crop, example is like glyphosate, paraquat and 2,4-D N-salt. And fourth type of herbicides, early post-emergence. Another application of herbicide in the slow-growing crops like potato, sugarcane, 2-3 weeks after sowing is classified as early post-emergence. Fifth basis of herbicide classification is based on molecular structure. On this basis, the herbicides are classified in two categories. First one is inorganic compounds and second is organic compounds. Here to study about formulations of herbicides. Herbicides in their natural state may be solid, liquid, volatile, non-volatile or soluble or insoluble. Hence, these have to be made in form suitable and safe for their field use. In herbicide formulation is prepared by the manufacturer by blending the active ingredient with substances like solvent, inert carriers, surfactants, stickers and stabilizer, etc. What are the objectives in herbicide formulations? It is first one is ease of handling and second high control activity on the target plants. And what is the need of formulations? To have a product with physical properties suitable for use in a variety of types of application, equipments and conditions. Second, to prepare a product which is effective and economically feasible to use. And third, to prepare a product which is suitable for storage under local conditions. So, on this basis, the different type of herbicide formulations are prepared. Now to study types of formulations. First one is इमल्सिफाइबल कंसनट्रेट्स ईसी, ए कंसनट्रेटेड हर्बिसाइड फॉर्मुलेशन कंटेनिंग ऑर्गेनिक सॉल्वेंट एंड एडजुवेंट्स टू फैसिलिटेट इमल्सिफिकेशन विथ वाटर, एग्जाम्पल लाइक ब्यूटाक्लोर. सेकेंड इज वेजिटेबल पाउडर्स डब्ल्यू पी, ए हर्बिसाइड इज एब्जॉर्ब बाई एन इनर्ट कैरियर टुगेदर विथ एन एडेड सर्फेस एक्टिव एजेंट. द मटेरियल इज फाइनली ग्राउंड सो दैट इट मे फॉर्म ए सस्पेंशन वेन एजिटेटेड विथ ए रिक्वायर्ड वॉल्यूम ऑफ वाटर, लाइक एग्जाम्पल एट्राजिन. थर्ड हर्बिसाइड फॉर्मुलेशन इज ग्रेन्यूल्स, द इनर्ट मटेरियल कैरियर इज गिवन ए ग्रेन्युलर शेप एंड द हर्बिसाइड एक्टिव इन्ग्रेडियंट इज मिक्सड विथ सैंड क्ले वर्मिकुलाइट फाइनली ग्राउंड प्लांट पार्ट्स विच इज ऑल्सो नोन एज ग्राउंड कॉर्न कॉप्स एज कैरियर मटेरियल एंड एग्जाम्पल्स आर एलाक्लोर ग्रेन्यूल्स. एंड फोर्थ टाइप ऑफ फॉर्मुलेशन इज वाटर सोल्यूबल कंसनट्रेट्स डब्ल्यू एस सी एंड एग्जाम्पल्स लाइक पाराक्वाट. सो दीज आर द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ फॉर्मुलेशन ऑफ हर्बिसाइड्स. नाउ टू स्टडी टाइम ऑफ एप्लीकेशन ऑफ हर्बिसाइड्स. द हर्बिसाइड्स आर अप्लाइड ऑन थ्री टाइप्स. फर्स्ट वन इज प्री प्लांटिंग, सेकेंड इज प्री इमरजेंस एंड थर्ड इज प्री इमरजेंस. फर्स्ट इन प्री प्लांटिंग एप्लीकेशंस, एप्लीकेशन ऑफ हर्बिसाइड बिफोर द क्रॉप इज प्लांटेड और सोन. सोयल एप्लीकेशन एज वेल एज फोलियर एप्लीकेशन इज डन हेयर. फॉर एग्जाम्पल फ्लूक्लोरलिन कैन बी अप्लाइड टू सोयल एंड इनकॉर्पोरेटेड बिफोर सोइंग रेनफेड ग्राउंडनट, वाइल ग्लाइफोसेट कैन बी अप्लाइड ऑन द फोलियज ऑफ पेरिनियल वीड्स लाइक साइप्रस रोटंडस बिफोर प्लांटिंग ऑफ एनी क्रॉप्स. सेकेंड मेथड इज प्री इमरजेंस एप्लीकेशन, एप्लीकेशन ऑफ हर्बिसाइड बिफोर ए क्रॉप और वीड हैज इमर्ज. इन केस ऑफ एनुअल क्रॉप्स एप्लीकेशन इज डन आफ्टर द सोइंग ऑफ द क्रॉप बट बिफोर द इमरजेंस ऑफ वीड्स एंड दिस इज रिफर्ड एज प्री इमरजेंस टू द क्रॉप, वाइल इन केस ऑफ पेरिनियल क्रॉप्स इट कैन बी सेड एज प्री इमरजेंस टू वीड्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल सोयल एप्लीकेशन बाई स्प्रेइंग ऑफ एट्राजिन ऑन थर्ड डे आफ्टर ट्रांसप्लांटिंग टू शुगर केन कैन बी टर्म्ड एज प्री इमरजेंस टू केन क्रॉप, वाइल सोयल एप्लीकेशन बाई स्प्रेइंग द सेम इमिडिएटली आफ्टर ए रेन टू कंट्रोल ए न्यू फ्लश ऑफ वीड्स इन ए इंटरकल्टिवेटेड ऑर्चर्ड कैन बी स्पेसिफाइड एज प्री इमरजेंस टू वीड्स. थर्ड इज पोस्ट इमरजेंस, हर्बिसाइड एप्लीकेशन आफ्टर द इमरजेंस ऑफ क्रॉप और वीड इज रिफर्ड एज पोस्ट इमरजेंस एप्लीकेशन. When the weeds grow before the crop plants have emerged through the soil and are killed with a herbicide, then it is called as early post-emergence. For example, spraying 2,4-D NSAL to control parasitic weeds, Striga in sugarcane is called as post-emergence, while spraying of paraquat to control emerged weeds after 10-15 days after planting potato can be called as early post-emergence. Now to study the factors influencing choice of herbicides. First factor is crop factor. Monocots and dicots show differential tolerance to a herbicide. Accordingly, depending on type of crop cultivated, the choice of herbicides varies. Like monocots like rice has tolerance to 2,4-D NSALT, while dicots like soybean gets killed when used as post-emergence. Second is nature of weeds present. Based on the types of major weeds present in a situation, the herbicides are suggested accordingly. Like example, if more grassy weeds are present, then flugipop-butyl is used, while 2,4-D NSALT is used to control broad-leafed weeds. Third is site of application. Soil-applied herbicides like atrazin, fluchlorelin, and foliar-applied herbicides like glyphosate. Now, fourth is time of application. Pre-emergence herbicide like metaclor, post-emergence herbicide like paraquat, and in farming situation under wetland conditions, water-soluble herbicides like butaclors are used, and garden land vegetable powders and atrazins are used, and in case of water bodies, dicot is used. Then duration of weed control. In case of short duration, less persistent herbicides like anilophos is used. For long period, residual herbicide like atrazin is preferred. So this was all about herbicides, its classification and application methods. Hope this presentation will be very, very helpful to all of you. Now my presentation ends here. Thank you very much. I have given here my YouTube channel details, Journey with Vijay Kumar Shrivastav. Having request, please visit the channel, subscribe it and provide your kind and valuable feedbacks. Thank you.